the trees!
Ah, help! Oh god, help! That was not how I intended to start that at all. Hello, my name is Zoster and Fire, and welcome back to Third Age Dawn of War, Thranduil's realm, as Prince Legolas the Aggressive attacks orcs that are surrounding Dunlasteer like a bunch of jerks. Take Captain Ugnag. Or mine. I'm gonna attack Ugnag, I guess.
Evil must not be allowed to triumph this day.
I know the men of Rohan. True and valiant, our allies, dwelling still in the lands that we gave them long ago. Boromir of Gondor, the Council of Elrond.
Continuing exactly where I left off last time. It's next day, but I'm continuing exactly off where I started off just because... Well, I still feel bad for cutting last episode short. I really just was that tired. That hungry. You know, I really probably should not push... doing videos to the way like that most of the time. All right, so let's see. Let's enable skirmish mode. Let's bring our infantry back. Darn it! Why do we have to be in the plains with Kaelin Nardon? I can't take advantage of any forest anywhere to hide my infantry while my archers run away like a bunch of headless chickens. Because I'm definitely not hanging my archers out to dry. What are you talking about? Yes. Anyway. Okay, so at least I have a bunch of fresh units here, like refreshed units now. Let's see. Oh, Legolas. Yes, Legolas. You will actually. Okay, we'll break these guys off into pairs, so hopefully the enemy will not chase all of my rangers in a single mass, which seemed to be a big problem before. You guys, I shouldn't have any problems now anyway because there's so many, because all orcs, you know, there's nothing to worry about in terms of trolls or anything. Hi, beeping sound, I'm appreciative of your presence. Let's switch up your position though. Let's switch up your position there, because I don't want these guys in the very front, I want them towards the rear. We travel from Lorien, good. Gonna move him up over here a bit, and we'll just hit anything that comes. Basically, we'll hit anything that comes at us in the center, with the infantry, while everyone else runs away like a bunch of headless chickens. Of course, I'm grouping up all my archers again, but they should split up based on their current formation, I think. Hold on. Let's adjust you a bit. Uruks, Uruk halberds, scouts, Uruk archers. Uruks. Okay, only a couple of archer units, it looks like. Alright, pull back. Yes, that's what I'd like to see. Okay, just run, please. Don't stand still, gentlemen. Run away. Run away like a bunch of smartlings. Let's ride these guys out here, I think.
We protect the Elven lands.
Oh gosh, they are. Okay, well, I guess. Okay, that. Not go quite the way I anticipated. Oopsie. I forgot they were gonna run out of javelins really fast. Whoopsie.
Continue like this, and we will smash the enemy.
Yep. Definitely did something completely derpy just now. Where are the hell are you going? Okay, well, okay, well, that was not the best decision I've ever made, is it? Well, mistakes were made. Not major mistakes, but certainly mistakes that might cause me a bit of trouble. In fact, you know what? We're just gonna gank them in the back. That sounds like a great idea. Okay. Let's just bring these guys in now. Let's just.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Yes, those are words I love to hear. I don't just like to hear them. I love to hear them. Oh, okay, I'm just kind of splitting these guys all up. Whoopsie. Bad decisions are still being made. Don't worry, you thought that would change within 3 minutes? No. I'm still gonna make stupid decisions. These archers are faring comically well, aren't they? Then again, they're mostly elite units, so, you know, I can't say I'm entirely surprised by that either. Where's the enemy general anyway? Because these guys have not broken yet. They were supposed to break ages ago. My foes. My dastardly foes.
Good tidings.
Yes!
The enemy general lies dead.
Oh god, why are you shooting us? Game, why do you do this to me? Why do you shoot our own men in the face? Why do you let my own men shoot my own men
the
in the
enemy army, please defend.
End the battle. 113 casualties. Good. Woodland spearmen that took very heavy casualties recovered. Less than half of that. But that's okay. I can't complain overly much about how that one turned out. And I totally botched that Elder Council. They recovered a little less than half, but they didn't take many to begin with, so whatever. I can't complain about that either. Our enemy can't meet the ransom. What a bunch of cheap bastards.
Our land will be
that's something
more,
the elves would say, right?
By the light of Elbereth.
Maybe I should have gone for these two instead.
My blade.
Because I really can't go after him without running out of movement points to get close enough to Dunlaustir. Because I don't really want to be caught out in the open. So.
Like the wind.
Back that way, and we'll just kind of stand by here. No, hiding in the forest is pointless, since they'll be able to see where I'm hiding. I'm just going to do it anyway. Because I feel like it's going to give me a bit of a boon in the end. Yes, the siege here by Captain Lugduff. Lugging his duff around. Like he's better than us. That's what the orcs feel about him anyway. Lugging his duff around. That's something orcs say, right?
Elves! At ease! Come, my brothers!
Let's see how we're doing here in terms of rebuilding the army. Not bad, okay. So Carverod is our next target. We're gonna take that, we're gonna trade it for Dornirhawk, and give ourselves another frontline position with which to deal with our enemy. I think that's our best bet here. You know, give ourselves another front line,
yes, my lord.
You know, to kind of distract the enemy with in Dornirhawk. You know, make sure it stays well supplied with reinforcements out of Burr Southis and out of Amon Lunk. Amon Lunk actually is probably going to be dedicated to other things, but Dor Lingvar probably. You know, going to be lots of lower tier units, unfortunately, but that's kind of just going to be something I have to deal with, so. Not only that, but in defensive battles in particular, lower tier units fare very well against Mordor, so. Especially behind walls. You know, the higher tier units are superior, are better for offensive maneuvers. So, did I save? Yes. I'm just checking the date. And then we're ending that turn.
Now we wait. I forgot about the spy and the Numinas. Anuminas.
Oh, hi. Hi, right. I forgot about this already, and I was paying attention. That's the worst part. I was paying attention. Okay. So, Olokai, Great Beast, they need to die. After that, there are also two ladders and two siege towers. Oh, please don't tell me this is gonna crash. Oh, please don't crash after this. If this crashes after this, I'm gonna have to find out a... May have to just do a console command and then... Maybe abandon it temporarily. Maybe trade it to Isengard for peace or something.
Our foes appear to be gaining the upper hand in this battle.
I hope that crashing is not tied to, to the map itself, and it's tied to something else. Let's see. Let's do that. And let's see here. You guys can hold that. You guys can hold that, I guess. Let's see. There's too many guys on the ground here. On the walls, I feel like. So, first of all, javelin men. Let's figure out a place where you can go on the ground. Ground. Go on the ground, javelins. Okay. Let's see. You guys, why don't we have any defenders over here? Let's put them there. That's a good idea. And that should do it, I think. Let's see. So, Lorien Spearman shall hold the front line here. Let's do this. Lorien Spearman shall hold there. These Lorien Spearmen and the Elbereth Guards shall hold about here. And then they'll all be backed up by offensively minded troops. You'll be backed up by, well, defensively minded Yavanna's Chosen. You are here in Ek, so I may have to have you cover the walls up here somewhere, so we'll be careful. So we'll keep you on standby. You are Gurdhinen. I have not used you yet with your two blades and your really, really awesome cloaks. Gurdhinen. Unfortunately, the only other way in the castle is really far away, so I really can't use them to kind of flank the enemy like I would really want to. So we're just going to put the Gurdhinen on each on the side. Alright, start the battle. But yeah, I'm hoping that, no, not the Halberds, the Great Beasts. Great Beasts. You guys, on the other hand, not you though. You guys, on the other hand, where are the Olokai? Olokai have ladders, but they can't actually use them, can they? So you're going to shoot the Great Beasts, since the Olokai are actually farther away than I thought they would be. You shoot the Olokai. I don't know if I'm making good tactical decisions at the moment. Where are the Elder? Okay, so you guys do not fire at will. In fact, let's put you over here where you can throw at the Olokai should the time come. And hopefully we can cripple the enemy's morale quickly by killing the Great Beasts and their javelineers, since the enemy commander's among them. Look out! Javelins! Oh no! Help! They can't throw them accurately at this distance. Good thing! Good thing they're completely incompetent at their jobs. Hooray! You know, if I could set even one of these on fire. I'm pretty sure I would get them to rampage like Mumakil.
Our enemy's ladders have reached our walls. It's time for butcher's work. The enemy siege tower is
ha! Ha ha! Ha! Take that! Take that, fools! I'm gonna let them rampage for a bit. You guys shoot that. Oh gosh, that siege ladder's on fire. Or that siege ladder. Siege tower. Fudge, you idiots! Get off the wall! Don't get back on the wall! I don't even know how that siege tower got set on fire. That's like pure dumb luck. Whoa! That guy spazzed out. I guess we're fighting there. Let's see. No, no battering rams coming up, that's for certain. And they're all coming up there. Uh-oh. That's not good. I'm pretty sure I turned off your fire arrows, guys. Okay, so what do I do here? Nope, not that door, you dumb butts. Well, that went well for them, didn't it? Alright, can I get you down off the walls there? While I bring the Gertinen in here. Oh, that poor swordsman. Hi, battering ram. What you doing there? You being a cheeky git too?
Curses! The enemy are battering down our gates.
No, no, you son of a stupid idiots! Come on, come in, go through the right door, please. Oh gosh, lag. Why is it lagging? The game is lagging like hell. I love how these guys just loitering over here, where it's like, there's a whole bunch of guys to trample over there, guys. Come on. Come on, you can do it. Oh gosh, why is the frame rate dropping so much? Whoa.
The enemy's ram is through our gates.
The frame rate is bad right now. This might be related to, Foldberg. At least that's my thought in the matter.
The enemy have the walls. Get to our defense or all will be lost.
Aha! Twin blades! Twin blades! Don't die pushing in. Please don't die pushing in, guys. Don't die overly much pushing in. That'd be appreciative. I would be appreciative. Okay, enemy climbing there. Enemy trying to push onto the walls here. Right, you guys shoot that. You guys are out of arrows. So what do I do with you? I don't know. I'll keep you on standby right there.
I hope they can't run through the gate. That'd be silly, and I hope they just can't run through the gate, really. The enemy commander actually didn't die yet, did he? And boom! Right through the enemy. Oh, God. Oh, they are... Okay, they are rampaging. They just routed a unit. They just flat-out routed a unit. No, waiting for something else to come through here, so... Alright, in fact, let's make that the unit that I attack there.
Only you guys actually... The enemy force remains.
Hey, gentlemen, there's things to trample over here. Hey, I can't whistle right now, but you know what I'm trying to do. You know there's something to rampage on right now. Right over here, come on. Hey, guys, right here. Right over here, right over diddly here. All right, let's bring these guys down here, actually. I want to start shooting at them again, because... All right, you guys get down here. Okay, you guys can actually attack there. That's actually a good idea. You guys come down here, though. What the hell? How did the halberd get there? Where did you come from? Where'd you come from, you cheeky git? I love how the AI is bugged so horribly that it's actually just doing everything wrong. Like, it's doing literally all the things that would get it killed. And then the game's probably gonna crash. I'm gonna win a bit. Okay, who isn't on the wall? Because that formation's definitely not the one you should be in. Some of them are just trying to flee back down. Others are trying to come up. It's really a gigantic mess up there. All because that siege tower burned and their elite great beasts just routed completely on them. The trees will hide us. Attack! I'm gonna bring these guys over here to help. You guys actually aren't supposed to be outside of the gate, are you? No, I don't want movement. No! Stop it! Shoot! I don't want movement, I want shooting! Okay, a bunch of enemy forces are routing. Are you guys even shooting at things? Oh, you're not. Okay. Well, we'll have you shoot the Uruks. I think there's like one Sauron's Will. There he is. Three of them. Three Sauron's Will kind of hiding out there, but...
Yes!
The battle seems to be swinging in our favor. From such tidings,
okay, we're gonna see if this game crashes after this. It'd be a pain in the butt if it did, though. We're gonna rush out here. We still have to kill these guys, but we're mostly dead, so... Alright, you guys come up here, I guess. Oh, wait, there's one left. One left. I think another volley would probably do it. Another volley or two. Because the rampage has run its course, I think. There we go, okay. Alright. Alright, come down here. This is probably all this effort where I'm just gonna have to cheat in the end. That's probably the worst part. This is probably all this effort and I'm probably just gonna have to end up cheating in the end, right?
just to ensure I could actually get past this. It's not where I wanted you to go at all.
Wait, why did you guys come out here? Why would you want to go down the siege tower instead of coming down out through the gate? Which would be easier by far.
Oh, and the javelineers have thrown nothing. They've thrown absolutely nothing. Wait, how much damage will they do to it if they start attacking it? Nothing. Okay, hold on. I think I can get them to... What happens if I make them go up the tower, though? What happens then? I'm surprised these guys are not breaking at all. In fact, I'm surprised the enemy's still fighting so stubbornly, all things considered. Don't worry though, the elves are overlapping each other just to get at you. I'm gonna run these guys in a bit. Try to get them a little more enmeshed in the enemy so that they start stabbing more of them so that they stop shooting! Alright, I guess we'll have you guys come into here. Okay, there we go! There we go. That's what I prefer to see.
Ready your swords.
There's only 7 of these left, jeez. Oh, the Olokai. I completely forgot about them. Shit. I totally forgot about the Olokai. Hold on, you guys back out there. You guys back out. The Olokai are so completely bugged, it's not even funny. I know, I have 2 elite archer units to actually keep shooting at them with. Great. I have to start throwing at them, so.
Stay alert. Forward, give them your spears.
Oh, the standard bearer survived that. That's funny. It's very funny. This should be pleasant. This definitely has no potential to end in disaster. Okay, 2 more died. Just in time for the javelins to come in. The elite armor-piercing javelins. The arrows are still doing more. Okay, that's good. Oh, there's another one down. Another one biting the dust, as it were. Oh, there's their ladder. There's their single ladder. Their single extraordinarily useful ladder, definitely not completely useless in any way, shape, or form. Did those all just miss? Did those really all just miss? Oh, those didn't, though. Okay, let's finish this, and let's see if the game crashes. Okay, okay, end the battle. Well, that's a lot of casualties, but we hope.
This is a great victory worthy of only the mighty.
But I recovered zero of those Gertie and I lost. Great game, great game, great job. All right, let's see if that crash is related to Foldberg or not, though. I'm just kind of obsessed with that crash, I know. It's just, I don't know what caused the crash. I don't know if that was something regarding Isengard or something regarding Foldberg specifically. Or maybe it's who controls Folder. I don't know.
You will ruin these trees no longer.
Nothing. Anson?
Protect the elven lands.
Nothing. Okay. Game is good to go, it looks like. Oh, there's a lot of Mordor forces heading this way. I have to make a couple of tactical decisions. You have to make a couple of very vital tactical decisions, diplomatic even, decisions.
Darwinian in decline.
Let's see. The ring has been located. Where the hell is this? Oh, it's located on, in Rune. Well, definitely not getting that now. Cuilwin. Okay. Morfindian is a master smith. Okay. Editor report. Thank you. Equipment report. Thank you. Relations report. Thank you. Grey Havens of Linden apparently happier with us for some reason.
My lord.
All right, you onward to the Shire has been reached.
Quietly.
Ooh, this is a new settlement. Caras Cal Caira Kravarber. West Numeriador, Rolandin. So you guys, you're just not trying to take back, you're not trying to take back the Grey Havens at all? Trying not to do that?
I will not waste words on you.
This Variag army apparently got really trapped back here. Actually, in fact, I imagine all the invasion armies got really trapped on their way back. We'll probably see, start seeing some of them, like, kind of filter back over time, but...
I'm gonna stick you!
Let's see here. What do I do here?
My lord.
Can I infiltrate the Hornburg? The My Hornburg, lord. Even. Oh, you're inferior to him, aren't you?
My lord.
Oh yeah, you're Morkion, so of course you're the better one. Okay, so I'm gonna have to do a couple of things here, I think. Because this is too beat up to do much more with.
My lord.
Let's see here.
Your orders.
Cretacean. Who else do I have here?
My lord.
Brachalian. Brachalian's pretty good, too. Not my best, but he's pretty good.
Have a taste of my blade.
Larzog.
Sire.
My lord.
Okay, I'm trying to be clever.
My lord.
Vriangeli. Okay, first of all, save. Vandal 5. Can Vriangeli get into...
Yes,
he can. Okay. It's only a 50% chance.
By the light of Elbereth!
That's your maximum distance, isn't it? Because I'm having thoughts in play. You're Mortimer Danny, and I need Morkion. Say, Thranduil 5, please infiltrate Morkion. I need you to. Yes, okay, good. Good. Yeah, I'm taking some pretty major risks this turn.
Them.
You weren't actually supposed to walk into him, you idiot! You knew he was there! That doesn't even make sense the way that happened. We knew he was there! Why did you walk into a zone of control?
This game does stupid crap like that sometimes. Like, it just walks them, like, right through a settlement when you know it's there, and it's just like, come on, that kind of pathing's ridiculous. That's okay. That's okay. Oh, crap. More cannons to go back in. There we go. Better. No, we know he's there. There's literally no reason you should be giving a path through his zone of control.
Take it for the elves.
There you go. Destroy. Damn it, the gate's not open.
Keep them off balance.
Yes, my lord. Approaching their
We shall hear you out, but
ceasefire, but we will give you a region in exchange for it. We will give you Foldberg back. Which makes that an off-balanced offer.
We have no complaints with this plan. We accept. Goodbye. We look forward to our next meeting.
This is just a temporary measure, though. It's a very temporary measure. That's a lot of peasants in there. What is... How do you have an 8 chevron peasant? That doesn't even make sense. Oh, no, it does make
Come,
sense.
My brothers.
Just, whatever. Damn it. That there's an army. There's
I'm
armies in the way.
Stick you. I'm gonna stick you.
You have 8 of us infiltrated, but we gotta clear off this road a little bit. What is the status of this one, of Gazbag's army here?
Have a taste of my blade.
That's a beatable one.
Elves.
That's certainly a beatable one.
By the light of Elbereth!
Oh, let's not forget over here either. Let's not forget about the east.
Elven warriors.
Let's start bringing you over here.
Onward. Be vigilant.
Let's start bringing you. Not yet.
Elven warriors.
With you. You have free upkeep still, so that's gonna work in my favor.
Come, my brothers! Sire!
As if you guys haven't picked up on what I'm trying to do right
Come,
now.
My brothers.
And I've barely picked up on what I'm trying to do right now, frankly, so. You're not alone! basically. I'm trying to see if I can take Aedorus and/or the Hornburg. Obviously, I can't take the Hornburg. Now I'm getting ganked
you.
In the back, at least. How close are you? You can't get really close enough, can
you?
You're close enough, though.
I'm gonna stick you!
I'm trying to take Hornburg, and I'm trying to take Aedorus, and I'm gonna see if I can't trade Aldberg for peace with Mordor. Gosh, if I can't trade Aldberg for peace with Mordor, I am so boned. Because I'm gonna have to evacuate Dunluster, and I'm gonna have to, like, pull... I'm just gonna have to pull back my entire front line, basically. That's basically what I'm gonna have to do. I'm gonna have to, like, pull back my entire front line back to, like, Unadrith and Rockburg, I guess. This will drag Eloth Lorien into the fight for a bit, though, so that will help me, but... Let's see, okay, if I pull you... I'm just trying to think, if everything goes tits up...
Follow
if
me.
I pull Maldor back into Fangorn for protection... Harrion's gonna be in trouble, but he's gonna... I think he can manage what he's gonna face. I'm also at peace with Isengard right now. Can you infiltrate here, by the way? Because we're going to take this back soon. We're gonna go back to war with Isengard soon enough. It's just... Fuck you. That was very vulgar. Load that. Back up. Oh, this is very, very challenging. Damn it. If only getting rid of Aedorus was easier. I mean, that's the problem I trip up on. Every time I conquer something, I take massive casualties. That's part of the problem. Or I take enough casualties that, like continuing on the push without, like, covering my rear is impossible. And all right, now.
My lord.
Morty Medanian, onward to here. The Foldberg is some Snaga and a few half-orcs. That's good.
Come, my brothers.
It's Legolas the Aggressive.
Assail.
Go for it! Yazbeg, you're mine!
Fight to
Death
the
shall be yours! Before you could use that power, you would need to become first. I already read that last episode.
Oh, this is so tense.
All right, because if I can clear the road, then I won't have to worry about losing the movement points going through the road. Actually, how many movement points does a character lose when they go through an enemy army? That's a good question. All right, you guys do that. Infantry. Ah, no, infantry. Infantry, you come back over here, actually. Okay, infantry can go back here. Gotta be careful of the... Ha! 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 Oh, let me just do this real quick before I forget. Skirmish mode, okay. Right, back to it. You guys over here... You guys take the lead because I can afford to lose you because you're the easiest to replace. Let's see. You guys go back here. Not going to put the Elder Council in front because that ended disastrously last time. Well, not disastrously, but ended poorly last time. Alright, start the battle. Where's the enemy trolls? There they are. So run these guys forward. Mountain trolls, you are my foe. Which is why we're going to focus everything we have on you. Except these two, actually. We're going to keep those two on standby. See, they don't have any armor, so that actually means that my archery does a massive number on them. No, you don't! Oh, you see that? You see that? Holy crap! The trolls! The trolls can't survive! One more, come on! Come on, do it! Yes! Now here comes everything else! Oh no! I'm fine, shut up. Alright, recondense your formations. Archery! Archery straight into their faces! Archery straight into their faces! How many casualties have been inflicted so far? 10%. Good. Those are numbers I love to see. Not just like, I love to see them! I love to hear the tales of how our enemies bled on the battlefield, etc. That's getting morbid, so I'm just gonna shut up. Oop, there's Sauron's will. I'm gonna shoot them a bit. Not gonna micromanage my horse archers because I'm so gonna forget about them otherwise. Pull back! Damn it, I put them on skirmish mode when I didn't need to. I hate it when I do that. Okay, here comes the enemy. Okay, I said the woodland rangers were easy to replace. I didn't mean I actually wanted you guys to attack them. Okay. Let your bows sing!
The battle is very much in our favor. Victory will be ours.
How did that happen? Game.
Okay, so far so good.
Enemy force remains.
No words I love to hear. Oh, that's the Uruk bodyguard. Shoot them! Shoot them! Shoot the enemy general! Gonna take advantage of that a bit. Alright, you guys go in there. You guys charge over. No, wait.
Abandons his men.
How did you guys manage to commit so quickly? Okay, I'm shooting my own forces from the front here, so they're much better protected against my shots, at least. Okay, we're gonna flank these guys here with Legolas and the other woodland Hinny Dower. I remember their names. Shut up. Hi, friends. We're on your flank, and now we're gonna shoot you. We're just gonna shoot you all from here. In a massive blob, jeez. There's something vaguely ridiculous about the fact they've all just completely clumped up there. Okay, looks like the enemy front has collapsed here. That flank attack is just what the doctor ordered. I don't know who that doctor is. But he's probably not Thranduil's. Oh, they shouted. Yes!
Foe runs. It's time to press the attack.
Continue. I want to massacre as many of them as possible. Okay, wait. Pull back. Don't continue the engagement. Because I want to make sure not many of them come back to haunt me after this. Let's see, I don't know what enemy unit. Is there any enemy unit in the lead in terms of the retreat? I don't know. I'm gonna shadow them for now, though. I'm gonna shadow them until they come out of range of my archers. I'll shoot that for a bit. Okay, you're shooting at that. Is anyone else shooting at this? I don't think so. Because most of the enemies kind of moved out of range now. Oh, there's some enemies over the crest. Though their general is dead, and once a general dies and they've taken sufficient casualties, armies usually just dissolve after that. You know, like a lot, there have to be a lot of survivors in the aftermath of a general's death. In order for the army itself to actually remain constituted as an army. As far as I've noticed, anyway. You know, that's been my base. That's generally been my observation, so. You know, like, this right here, this probably is not going to This probably is not going to last into the back into the strategic mode, so. But I still play anyway. I still make sure that these don't withdraw to Aedirus before I can reach Aedirus. Assuming I can reach Aedirus. I don't know. Oh, I never got the general. Oh. 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 I didn't. Oh, ha. Oh, whoopsie. Oh, so they would have retreated to Aedirus had I not actually done this. Well, that's good to know. Yep. Mm-hmm. Totally good to know. Totally good to know that I am a doofus. Okay, I think that should do.
Yeah. This is a
180 casualties. We can deal with that, especially since we've covered a lot of the higher casualty units anyway. With the Mythair Thaiwar, or however you pronounce that. I never pronounced that right, I'm pretty sure. But I just pronounce it the way I see it, the way I read it. Which is probably wrong. Alright, let's see what happens.
Stay in the tree.
Execute! He doesn't live. Not today. Relations worsened. Hooray!
We've defeated their wretched army.
As I'm sure Mordor loved us before. Let's save. Thranduil 5. Oh, please let this gate be open. Damn it!
To ruins. It's end.
So we're about to be flanked by something here. I should see what the next turn brings. Maybe I should evacuate Dun Lostir for good measure, though. Hmm. Or maybe. I don't know. Hold on. Hi, Dunafell. How are you?
My lord. Approaching quietly.
What kind of... Doesn't look like there's an orcish presence over here. So that might work in my favor.
I'm gonna
Captain Larzog is here. I have not been timing this episode at all, have I? Darn it. In both cases, though, the gates weren't open. That figures. I mean, it's less than 50% for each, I guess, so. It makes sense. It's just disappointing, I guess, is the problem. No, maybe it'll be open next turn. If anything, I can just storm the castle like traditionally. In both cases, they're under-defended, assuming the enemy doesn't attack me from the rear, which I'm assuming they're going to. I just realized there's two armies that are going to get Legolas. And you can't recruit anything in the region. Disappointing. Oh boy. Next turn really is going to... Is really going to... be the determining factor of whether or not everything goes to hell in this region. Though if I can get away with my generals, since my generals are all kind of elite generals here... Maldor really isn't an elite general, but he's got an elite bodyguards unit. Is there anything we can recruit in one turn? No, of course there isn't. But I can recruit things. I can try to recruit things in the meantime. See if it makes a difference. These are just all placeholders, so I might as well just recruit everything I can there. Because if I can get Aedirus and the Hornburg, Mordor will break off its offensive. It will break off all of its attacks on Dun Lostir, because Dun Lostir obviously looks the most vulnerable to it. You know, so that obviously is preferable. And then I already have a strong front line in both Aldburg and Unadrith. So, you know, I can cover these if I can just break Mordor's presence in this region.
They will not see
depending on what course. Happens, this episode might end up running Come over. Hold on. I gotta be sure I'm building all the right things. Okay, someone's just blasting our window with blown snow. That's great. Okay,
maintain siege. Have your weapons ready, elves.
Sire,
what do I have you... Oh, we can't build ladders here. Okay, right. Right, because of course you can't build ladders there. Wait, siege towers are useless in Aedirus too. What am I doing? Battering rams, okay.
Its end draws near!
Alright, save game again, just to be sure that all's saved. And here's the moment of truth! Dun Lostir is doomed if I don't do this. I forgot about this again.
Okay, predicted outcome number one is going.
Let's get Zug's army look like again. Trolls, right. 9 trolls.
I can beat that! Put an end to this. I faced more! Greater numbers, even. Whatever! I'm gonna do this!
He staggered and fell, grasped vainly at the stone, and slid into the abyss. Fly, you fools! He cried, and was gone. Gandalf, the Bridge of Khazad-dûm.
Okay. Start deployment.
Let's see here. Okay, so we have the Hornburg to our back, right? I forgot that this actually was an element of this map. The enemy, I'm presuming, is going to come from, like, that spot there. There's going to be one enemy unit coming from behind, but I can handle that easily. We're going to go traditional defensive line with this, rather than some fancy strategy. You guys come here to the center. You guys back them up. Oh, the Lorien spearmen all got combined together. Crap. So what? That's not what I needed. I needed multiple units of them. But I'll make do. It's not the worst thing in the world. That, what the hell? Game! Game! Jeez. Gerd Hinen. Axeman. Who's left over here? Okay, you guys. Okay, our army is a bit pitiful, but it's just got the advantage of being the fact that it's actually strong, so. Anything missing? No. Start the battle.
They're bringing in reinforcements.
Right, reinforcements coming up from over there. What? Game? That doesn't make any sense, so you know it. They're not even going to enter the battle before I beat this army. That much is certain. You think they'd be coming from the Hornburg, of course, but no, apparently the game just doesn't... Apparently this map is just not designed right in that regard. Alright. As they come into range, I'm going to bombard those trolls with everything I have. But first, we speed it up, because it's going to be moving too slowly otherwise. Now we play the waiting game. Okay. Some of the enemies come into range somewhere. Or are they in the pretend to shoot zone? Nope, they're not in any zone now. Stand by. The Gerd Hinen are currently hidden because they can hide anywhere. Because of course they can hide anywhere, even on barren slopes that you can't hide in. Sure game, whatever. Oh boy. Okay, let's get this. Okay, there we go. As soon as I did that, of course it. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. No, you guys shoot the halberds. That's good. It's fine. Okay, trolls are starting to drop off. 2 of them are gone now. Okay, one more. Come down over here.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
You guys shoot that. Oh, there's a gap in the line right there. Alright, you guys charge down into the gap. You guys plug that hole. Keep shooting that. You guys shoot that. Okay, you guys can shoot that for a volley. Okay, you guys all just shoot the archers for now, I guess. Because there's a lot of enemies here that need to be dealt with. Hi, friends! How are you? You guys come down on the flank there of the enemy.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
That's what I like to hear. Oh, I inadvertently stuck the swordsman there. Okay, these Guardian are really getting beat up here. Let's give him some support in the form of all of the elven swords I can muster. I completely forgot about you guys.
The battle is very much in our favor. Victory.
These Gurdinen are winning very well, though, but they're taking heavy casualties as well. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, so bear with me, as usual, if I'm pronouncing it wrong. I mean, after all, whichever elven language that is not my first language, so... Oh, there they go. No, they're just breaking off, I guess, but whatever. Works in my favor because it gives me more opportunities. Yes! All right. Gonna do the rally troops thing, even though I don't really need it at the moment. I see you over there! You're gonna get dealt with. Gotta help there.
Behold how our cavalry runs. It's time to press the attack.
End the battle or continue it? Continue it. I need to be as thorough as possible every time I do these things, so.
The enemy are utterly,
utterly
vanquished.
Vanquished!
This is a great victory. Worthy of only the mightiest of generals.
I said that right, shut up. 169 casualties and an army of 800, that's very bad. Especially since I recovered so few of them because there's no doctors here. And I love how the garrison out of the Hornburg never actually reached the fight because of the way it spawned. You're just out of range, though, right? Yes, you are. You, on the other hand, this could be a problem. I forgot it to kill you, son of a crap. This is doing exactly what I wanted it to, though, except you. You are a problem.
This is our last stand, my friends.
This ties back into my greater strategic meta thingy.
We must defend these.
We've defeated their wretched armies.
Right, sack the settlement. I should have evacuated Dunlasteer. Well, then again, if assume I can do the thing right. We'll see. We'll see. Because I really don't want to lose Dalian. But I may just have to accept it as a consequence of my actions. On the other hand, I just realized losing Dunlasteer completely defeats the purpose of taking Aedaras. Mission success! One unit of Elder Pathfinders, hooray. The settlement besieged, Anadrith. Settlement besieged, Dunlasteer. What's your army?
I'm gonna stick you.
Only orcs, but I have so few troops here that I may not met. But I had just enough elites and a bit of artillery. I might be able to pull it off. But oh, that's gonna be the riskiest battle ever. That's gonna be the, because I'm badly outnumbered. That's the chief problem, I'm badly outnumbered there. We'll see though. Okay, hold on. Up here, first the spy. The spy, Mr. Spy. Onward, no, I don't want you to. No. Okay, we can't cross the river. Okay. Really, they haven't taken. They have all these armies here. Why didn't they take this back yet? Ooh, look, a new unit card for the Elder Windwe Swordsman. I like it. I remember it was a little different before, I'm pretty sure, so. And there was a Mithlan Nobles. Oh. I miss Linden. I wouldn't play them again because part of the reason that series lasted so long is just because of the way they play. You know, so it's that, you know, I really would not play them again just to avoid that outcome again.
I'm gonna stick you!
By the light of Elbereth!
Take it for the elves!
Save here. And we'll 4.
Assail them!
Attack! Okay, Gazdush will join the fight unless I attack at night. Then it's just Captain Zagoog! Yes!
Evil must
be
allowed to triumph.
What am I doing? Besides being weird? The interbreeding of orcs and men produced both men orcs large and cunning and orc men treacherous and vile. Saruman's crime, Morgoth's ring. All right. This is going exactly as I wanted to, frankly. So let's not do the wrong thing. Okay, let's do that. There we go. Okay, we could probably position way closer to the walls right now. Well, the battering ram does not have many places to go, so it's gonna go like here, I guess. I'll have a little closer here, I guess. And then it can just push on from there. But then everything else falls to the archers. So we're just gonna make one great big line of archers. Right? I did save before this, right? I'm not gonna have to go through a whole bunch of crap in the beginning of the turn crap again if something goes wrong, right? By wrong, I mean technically wrong, not like I lose the battle wrong. I'm not gonna do that. Start the battle.
Ready, elves.
Looks like the enemy is where? Where's the enemy? Besides, not in range of any of my archers, surprisingly. They're not at the heart of the city. Where are they?
Rohan may be dead, but their legacy shall live on somehow. I'll make sure of it. After I do all the things to make sure that the men of Eros follow me. Follow me, where is the enemy army? Am I misinterpreting where they are right now? Oh, they're up there. Okay, I am misinterpreting where they are. Dun da dun da dun da da dun da 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 da. Okay, I'm not going to do that, don't worry. Well, not doing much anyway. Okay, speed it up. A few archer units are now in range, so we're gonna start shooting up the hill. Oh wait, now the enemy's coming down the hill. Okay.
The gate with a battering ram.
Good. Good. This will make my job easy. Apparently they are so not confident in their own victory that they are just coming to meet me, or meet their own deaths at the very least. Just the way I prefer it.
The battering ram has done its work.
That was kind of ludicrous the way that happened.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
And then they go back up the hill. There they go. Goodbye. Bye, guys. You guys have a good time. Hey, it's been a while since I actually inadvertently hummed things in this, recording an episode, hasn't it? Because all of this was... Because that was just all totally inadvertent. I don't try to hum ever, but... It just happens. I was kind of missing this theme anyway. I like this theme a lot. Da-da-da! Alright, I'm gonna bring these guys up the hill. Just the elite infantry. No one else. Alright, everyone run forward. Everyone run into the town. Oh, right, I forgot about you guys. We'll just rain arrows on them from above. Because we're not really shooting straight from here, are we? Well, some are, actually. But not all of them. Doesn't matter in the end. I probably should not do that because I'm probably totally off... I'm probably, like, just, like, a few seconds... Like, probably, like, just, like, a millisecond off there. It's gonna sound really awful. Hey, it's the moon! Hi, moon! How are you, moon? You good? Good? Good. Very good. Actually, it's a lot of straight shooting as opposed to arced shooting, so... Hold on, I'm just gonna stay here. Backspace. Don't even start. No, you keep moving. Oh, there's the enemy commander, I'm guessing. The orcs are just like, what do we do? The elves are come. I can't remember what they call the elves. I don't remember the elves in the orcs' tongue. Or the Black Suit of Mordor, whichever one we usually heard them say it in was. The bright, shining ones have come at any rate. This looks completely ludicrous.
like overkill.
Holy... We've taken control of the city.
We take control of the square just by standing in the very edge of it. We're not even in it. We're right outside of it. And yet we're seizing control of the city that way. This seems like overkill. Like this is like this. That's like Boromir overkill right here. All these arrows right here. This is Boromir overkill. Like how many times can you shoot a man? Because unlike the portrayal in the movies, he was apparently hit by many, many arrows and javelins probably before he finally fell. So I'm just gonna watch this. There's literally nothing else to do here. Just watch this ludicrousness, ludicrosity. He's just a captain. He shouldn't be alive after all this. Seriously.
Tidings. The enemy general.
There you go.
Dead.
That took forever.
This is a clear victory.
Yes.
0 casualties. Ah. Oh. Wait, how do the woodland spearmen gain experience? Or unless they're the ones driving the battering ram? Is that how that works? Using a siege engine gives you experience? By the Nalgrim, the Kyrth were taken east over the mountains and passed into knowledge of many peoples. Dwarves learned Sindar letters. Silmarillion. Yeah, I just stumbled over that.
We protect the Elven lands. Guard this area.
Why doesn't sack the settlement? We already know the population's gonna be too big. And suddenly everything's crazy. Okay, I still have a tiny bit of culture left over here. So we're gonna start building new culture buildings. The Hornburg. Oh, hey friend. Can we actually hold this? Now I think about it, this is a mountain region, isn't it? Yep. Which means that recruiting things is going to be very difficult here. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Archery range. Royal Hall, look at that. All the leftovers of... Alright, so before I leave... this episode, I'm going to do something real quick. I'm going to see if the enemy drops the siege of Dunlasteer, or if I have to be all diplomatic about this and hope for the best. There's West Emnet, East Emnet, East Fold, Kingsland. I don't think West Emnet borders that, so... I just want to check this real quick, so just bear with me for a second. I forgot about something! Hold on. I'm probably going to go back anyway. Let's see. I'll probably go back in. I'm definitely gonna go back anyway. It doesn't matter. This is actually just me sating a bit of morbid curiosity I have as to regarding whether or not the enemy actually will maintain the siege of Dunlasteer or not. Given that I've now cut off all of their links to Dunlasteer by land. Okay, you're besieging Aldberg. That's okay, though. Aldberg's
not being...
We
must protect the people!
In serious threat. Edoras is about to fall under siege, I guess. No, it's not. It's just under... Wait, what? What's going on here? Hold on, I guess he done lost deer. I'm definitely going back, because I have... Falafiel. Let's see. Budding bureaucrat, confident defender, siege expert. Loyal, obedient... Sure. Bruinian decline. New mission. Okay. Let's Dunharrow, apparently. Okay. 1500 gold for Dunharrow, because Dunharrow's so useful. Let's see. Dunlasteer's still under siege.
I'm gonna stick you.
We'll see how this pans out next turn. Or next episode, rather. Let's just check all this for posterity. Alenian is now a tactician. Nethifarasan, I guess. As a javelin, Varyangli as a dancer. Okay, good. That's gonna help there. Barracks for Burst Southis. Right? Right, lots of upgrading is to be done here. At least I have 100,000 gold now. Which is a big improvement. Alright, so I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back though, because there's some things I didn't do in order to sate said curiosity, so. Thank you all for watching this episode of Third Age Total War. The Sylvan Elves, I hope that you enjoyed this episode as much as I did. I just took a couple of huge risks and they paid off. I'm glad for that. If you enjoyed this episode, be sure to leave a like and a comment. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. I'm totally forgetting my outro here because I've been doing this for like an hour and a half now. So, also check out the links in the description below to links to my Twitch channel, to my Twitter and Facebook pages, and I will catch you next time. As Thranduil's Realm, gosh, I'm forgetting everything from the outro. As Thranduil's Realm continues the war against Mordor. Right down here in this little, you know, this little right here. You know, this little region here? Yeah. Until next time, everybody.
Whatever. Whatever. The arrows of the dwarves are upon you right now. Here they come. Get ready.